We are delighted to have you here, especially because this was one of those events that had to be postponed because of the weather back in January. So thank you so much for making this a part of your life today and for the students who came this afternoon and have been rehearsing. You know, it just dawned on me as I'm seeing some of the students waving to their parents. Here I am. They're all wearing their white MLK shirts, and you're probably still trying to find your student. Let me do this. Let me start over here, and I'm going to say the name of the school, and you raise your hands and wave at your parents, or just wave at the audience, and your parents can find you, okay? We're going to start right here with Dunn Elementary, Adams Elementary, Peach is next, Amos is next, followed by Thornton, Mary Moore, Ellis, Johns, Farrell, Webb, Morton, Rankin, Miller, Butler, Bevensee, and Blanton. All right, Bevensee. You notice Dunn started out so nicely and very quietly. Congratulations, they made it over there with Bevensee and Butler. I'm Barbara Keaton. I'm the Fine Arts Coordinator for Elementary and Choral Music, and it has been my pleasure to work this program for many, many years. I've been with the committee for most of its 35 years in existence, so I've had a wonderful, wonderful time with this event and the other events that comprised our four-day weekend. I would like to start out by welcoming our MC for the night, but pardon me while I read, because I don't want to leave out anything in his career that is on my sheet right here. His name is Antonio Young. He is an eighth grade U.S. history teacher at Gunn Junior High and Fine Arts and Dual Language Academy. He previously taught at Dunn and Ellis Elementary. Since joining Arlington ISD, Antonio has recorded and released 9 educational and inspirational rap videos with the assistance of AISD's media team. Some of their videos have gone viral, garnering the attention of People Magazine, the Dallas Morning News, Access Hollywood, the television program, and various other news outlets. Because Antonio has frequently included his students who rap, dance, sing, make props, or simply portray fictional characters in his videos, Antonio was named the Dallas Cowboys' first ever Teacher of the Month in October of 2020. A former newspaper reporter and a 12-year teacher, Antonio also contributes to Arlington ISD's website as a freelance blogger, writing numerous stories that vividly capture the many great happenings across the district. Last but not least, he solely operates a DJ business called Still Young Entertainment, through which he DJs for school dances and retirement villages and assisted living facilities throughout North Texas. Let's take a look.
Our history is so sweet, like Reese's, an extension of George Carver's peanut invention. You feel me? Have the courage to lead, like Otis Borkin did with electronics. You can be that great if you work the hardest.
This is our truth, our treasure. This is our truth, our treasure. Black history so rich, it cannot leave
our
you
truth, our treasure.
In the 60s, Dr. King shed his dream that all people would be free, not me, no matter the color. We're sisters and brothers, and we should just love one another. Live in harmony, fight for equality, for our society. Advance his dream for peace, that's just how it's gotta be.
Wake me up, people, stop hitting snooze. Stay focused every day, you don't wanna lose. Getting educational is yours, a must, because the future falls on you.
Wake up, wake up, wake up.
A student with a goal, everyday practice self-control. Wake up thinking about your future, go learn all you need to know. Peer pressure is hard for sure, but have that courage to lead. Be the first one to take out a book to read and indeed believe that's how you're gonna succeed. You know what I mean? Follow that rule.
School is about to start, and AISD will shine from the teachers to admin. Everybody across the district, show the nation superstar employees on a mission.
With the ministry, AISD, we're on a mission, the best in the nation, giving kids a remarkable education and a lot more.
Mr. Antonio Young. Good evening, everyone. Welcome to our MLK Youth Extravaganza. I'm honored to be your MC this night. I have to say this for two reasons. Number one, I'm an 80s baby. So that meant that it was only just some years removed away from Dr. King's passing in 1968 when I was learning about him as a kid in the 80s. So he quickly became one of my heroes learning about him. And also, because I am an AISD teacher, I get to see all the talent among the students every day. So to see more talent tonight makes me smile. So I want to say this here. This concert concludes what would have been Arlington's four-day weekend of events celebrating and commemorating the life and work of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. Now, as you guys know, we had some winter weather in Texas, if that's a thing. I'm only saying that because I'm originally from Chicago, so I know what cold weather is like. But I do want to say this year, we would have had a gala, a poetry night, an ecumenical service, a day of service, and we finally arrive at this final event, the Youth Extravaganza. You'll see and hear hundreds of Arlington students as we celebrate Dr. King in song, word, drumming, and dance. The invocation and welcome will be given tonight by the pastor of Fielder Church's Pioneer Campus, Pastor Larry Dan Melton. Fielder Church has generously hosted this MLK Youth Extravaganza for many years, and we are truly grateful for the church's donation of time, talent, and space. Please join me now in thanking and welcoming Pastor Larry Dan Melton.
On behalf of Fielder Church, we want to extend a welcome. We are so grateful to be part of a city that celebrates the legacy of Martin Luther King Jr. And like him, we have a dream of being a place where diversity is celebrated. One of our values is we pursue imperfect people, and the reason why we pursue that is because we all are imperfect. But it is through the love of Jesus that we all are equal at the foot of the cross, because Jesus took our place. And Dr. King helped us to understand that we could celebrate diversity because it's rooted in love, and God is love. And he challenges us to live out that dream as Dr. King had, to welcome, to celebrate, to include. But we have to all be part of owning that dream. We have to all be part of taking our step. And we're honored as Fielder Church to partner with you, AISD, to partner with the committee, to partner with our mayor and our superintendent, and everybody that's in this room, parents and students. We welcome you because we believe that dream is worth investing in. We believe that that dream is worth taking steps to make a difference. That's the reason why we partner with AISD. We see the value in diversity, therefore we celebrate it. Can I open us with a word of prayer? Jesus, we thank you because you ultimately were the one that brought unity. Because of your love, you stepped into brokenness and you give us a heartbeat to love others. You've challenged us to love our neighbor as ourselves, which is exactly what Dr. King was about, is to stepping into difficult situations, to being a voice of hope and reason, to help people see that the vision of future can be better as we stand united. Though our skin colors may be different, our heart is the same. We are one people under God. And I pray your blessings over these families tonight. I pray that you would be with this school as we march forth, holding hands, being unified in that dream of Dr. King, so that we can love others, Jesus, as you first loved us. It's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Now it is my pleasure to introduce to you our brand new AISD superintendent, Dr. Matt Smith, and our Arlington mayor, the Honorable Jim Ross.
Good evening, everyone. My name is Matt Smith, and I am the proud superintendent of Arlington ISD. I just gotta say thank you real quickly to the parents sitting out here today. I'm looking at these kids in front of us, and I know the hours of rehearsal that goes on at school, but I also know the hours of singing that probably go on at home too. So please join me in thanking the parents for having the students participate tonight and be a part of this great celebration. I want to say real quickly a thank you to the committee members. I'm obviously proud of Arlington ISD staff and Aaron Perales, our chair, who did such hard work to pull off such an amazing event this evening. But the partnership between the Ministerial Association, the City of Arlington, Tarrant County Community College, and University of Texas at Arlington, those partnerships, and I've mentioned this multiple times, create such a synergy in this community. And when we're focused on this partnership for doing whatever we can for each and every citizen of our community, and most importantly to me, each and every student that you see in front of you today, it really is something special in this community. So thank you all for being here tonight. Thank you for the effort that you put in, and thank you for the effort that you'll continue to put in throughout the year to continue to make Arlington a great place for each and every one of our students. And now it's my pleasure to welcome Mayor Ross.
What's up, Arlington? How y'all doing tonight? 35 years we've been celebrating Dr. Martin Luther King. We could take lesson after lesson after lesson from Dr. King. One of the things that always sits home with me, and we talked about this last year when I was up here, is hate. You know, hate is a learned emotion. When we are born, when we are small children, we don't hate. You put a group of small kids in a room and they don't care what color the kid is. They don't care what ethnicity, what culture. They don't care about any of that. They care about their friends. It's as we get older and we allow life experiences to teach us how to hate. But Dr. King told us, hate isn't strong enough to do away with hate. The only thing strong enough to do away with hate is what? Love. That's the only emotion, the only thing strong enough to eliminate the hate. So I want y'all to do something with me that we did last year. On the count of three, I want y'all to look at somebody near you. They may not look like you. They may be younger. They may be older. They may be darker. They may be lighter. I don't care. I want, on the count of three, for y'all to say, I love you. Ready? One, two, three. I love you. Now, doesn't that feel good just to say I love you to somebody? Y'all, I love you. Thank you for being out here. Thank you for celebrating Dr. MLK. God bless y'all.
All right. Some amazing words from some amazing gentlemen. I just want to echo Mayor Ross just one moment as he was talking about diversity and loving each other. As a longtime teacher, that's one of the aspects of my classroom has always remained, that I can connect with all of my students regardless of what they look like and embrace everything that they bring to the classroom. So thank you, sir. All right, y'all ready for some entertainment? All right, it's all about the students tonight. And so at this time, would you please stand and join our MLK choir in singing the first verse of Lift Every Voice and Sing. The words are printed in your program. All right, standing before you are some amazing students and music teachers from 16 of our elementary schools. These students and teachers have been preparing their music during the fall and rehearsing together this afternoon to form our 2024 MLK Choir, and they are directed by our talented MLK Choir Director, Johnny Maples. Music teachers, please stand as the audience joins me in thanking you. All right, this weekend's theme is Advancing the Dream, a path forward to impact change across generations. And to that end, our choir's first song has a simple message for our younger generations. And it's basically, it's in our hands. The future of America is in our hands. We cannot wait. We have to do what we need to do to make our world better.
My name is Ashley Smith. I'm the music teacher at Peach Elementary. Shh, is there anything? Yes. And we are, of course, you know, I like to have a good time. So we're going to have a good time with this one. It's going to go into a very special, solemn song that was known as the Civil Rights Anthem. But we're going to start with a song that was written by Stevie Wonder, which inaugurated making MLK's birthday a national holiday. So I'm going to ask you to clap. Y'all welcome my husband, Mr. Nigel River, the teacher at Ellis. On bass, and your beautiful children. Ready? All right, here we go. Hit it, Joel. There you go.
Doesn't make no sense. There ought to be a law against anyone that takes offense to a day full of your celebration. But we know deep in our minds that we all should take the time and put some time aside just to show how much we love you. And I'm sure you can agree, nothing could be perfectly than to have a world party on the day you came to be. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday. Happy birthday to you.
All right, here's the next part. You know it.
Sing happy birthday. Happy birthday. Happy birthday. Happy birthday. Happy birthday.
right. The choir's last song is actually a chant highlighting the great American we have been honoring tonight and this past weekend. It emphasizes his work to brotherhood, justice, equal rights, liberty, and freedom. Let's get ready for the Martin Luther King chant. Awesome job, choir. Excellent, excellent. All right, students and teachers, we appreciate your talents and your hard work, and we also appreciate your dedication to this day as you help us celebrate the life and legacy of Dr. Martin Luther King. Thanks to all of you, your parents, and our guests for being here today. Audience, will you find the list of schools and their music teachers listed in your program? They are from Adams, Whitney Johnson, Amos, Veronica Malone, Bebency, Maya Jones, Blanton, Carla Munty, Butler, Teresa Francis, Dunn, Amy Hogan, Ellis, Nigel Rivers, Farrell, Johnny Maples, Johns, Antonice Roberson, Miller, Glenna Thomas, Collins, excuse me, Moore, Anna Minger Johnson, Morton, Brittany Coffey, Peach, Ashley Smith, Rankin, Melissa Balderas, Thornton, Tamara Edwards, and Webb, Sarah Landon. Let's give them another hand, you guys. All right. Since 1985, led by founder Lisa Thompson, the step-by-step dance studio has been an integral part of the Arlington community. Now under the direction of Erica Thompson, the studio participates in many different community events throughout the year, as well as continuing their tradition of performing at MLK celebrations for more than 20 years. The mission of step-by-step has always been to educate and train dancers to appreciate dance as an art form and to develop high self-esteem, discipline, and self-confidence that can be carried to other activities and professional settings. And they will dance to Spirit by Beyoncé.
Of paradise. trembling, that's when the magic happens. And the stars gotta fly by your side. And rise up to the light in the sky. Let the light lift your heart up. Burn your flame through the night. Yeah.
All right, amazing job, ladies. In August 2023, we celebrated the 60th anniversary of Martin Luther King's I Have a Dream speech. The theater department from Gunn Fine Arts and Dual Language Academy presents a student-written, directed, and performed short play about the impact of Dr. King's life on the modern student. Please give a warm welcome to the stage, Jeffrey Carlton, Nyara Lopez, and my homeroom and social studies student, Miracle Burns.
How do we even begin?
Your assignment is to create a short presentation capturing the life, history, meaning, legacy, and lessons of someone who is not only one of the greatest Americans to ever live, but one of the most influential people of all time, Dr. Martin Luther King Jr.
What words are even appropriate?
I've been learning about him since before kindergarten.
We look up to him.
Towering above like a soaring mountain.
His power is as mighty as his influence far-reaching.
And he is so intimidating to write about.
Okay. Well, we have to start somewhere.
Got it.
Guys, stop sitting around. This presentation is due tomorrow, and we have nothing to show for it.
Ugh, fine. Well then, where should we start?
A good place to start is the who, what, when, where, why.
Well then, who was Dr. King?
He was a hero.
An icon.
A baddie, a bee.
Focus!
Man, can't we just find this guy on TikTok?
Of course not, stupid. Plus, I already tried that.
Are you kidding me? We only have 2 hours to complete this.
Well, lucky for us, I already did all the research.
Really? Wait, where?
On Wikipedia.
Oh my gosh.
Okay, well, at least it's something. Come on, what did you find?
Well, it says here that he won the Nobel Peace Prize in 1964. His father was a preacher. He wrote, 5 books. And This can't be right. It says here he went to college when he was 15.
What? Oh, my 15-year-old brother does is play Fortnite.
It also says he attended Morehouse College in Atlanta under a special wartime program. It says it was his first extended away from home and his first experience of race outside the segregated South.
It's so sad that he had to go all the way north just to see different races worship together under the same roof.
I can't imagine what that would be like to have to go so far from home just to experience sharing a meal with someone of a different color.
Yeah.
Hey, look here. It states that before the March on Washington, he and multiple others were protesting for it to be possible for people of color to receive jobs.
I didn't know he did that.
Neither did I.
Look what I found. It's a video and a PDF of the I Have a Dream speech.
Really?
Maybe we can use that as our presentation. Here, send it to me.
There, sent.
Let me give it a shot. I have a dream.
No! Look, this cannot and it will not be cheesy.
It can't be flippant.
And that's why this just doesn't seem possible. So many people have said so much about him. Who are we to even try? It just seems like too big of a task.
No. Nothing was too big for Dr. King. From the voting rights to the segregation, he never stopped fighting for what was right. So why should we give up so easily? This time, let's try the speech together. Let us not wallow in the valley of despair. I say to you today, my friends, so even though we face the difficulties of today and tomorrow, I still have a dream. It is a dream deeply rooted in the American dream that one day this nation will rise up and live out the true meaning of its creed. We hold these truths to be self-evident that all men are created equal.
I have a dream that one day on the red hills of Georgia, the sons of former slaves and the sons of former slave owners will be able to sit down together at the table of brotherhood.
I have a dream that one day, even the state of Mississippi, a state sweltering with the heat of injustice, sweltering with the heat of oppression, will be transformed into an oasis of freedom and justice.
I have a dream that one day my four little children will live in a nation where they will not be judged by the color of their skin, but by the content of their character. I have a dream today.
I have a dream that one day down in Alabama with its vicious racists, its governor having his lips dripping with the words of interposition and nullification, that one day down in Alabama, little black boys and black girls will be able to join hands with little white boys and white girls as sisters and brothers. I have a dream today.
I have a dream that one day every valley shall be exalted, every hill and mountain shall be made low, the rough places will be made plain, and the crooked places shall be made straight, and the glory of the Lord shall be revealed, and all flesh shall see it together.
This is our hope. This is our faith that I go back to the South with this faith. We will be able to hew out the mountains of despair, a stone of hope. With this faith, we will be able to transform the jangling discords of our nation into one beautiful symphony of brotherhood.
With this faith, we will be able to work together, to pray together, to struggle together, to go to jail together, to stand up for freedom together, knowing that we will be free one day. This will be the day when all of God's children will be able to sing with new meaning. My country, 'tis of thee, sweet land of liberty, of thee I sing. Land where my fathers died, land of the pilgrim's pride, from every mountainside, let freedom ring. And if America is destined to be a great nation, this must become true. And so, let freedom ring from the prodigious hilltops of New Hampshire. Let freedom ring from the mighty mountains of New York.
Let freedom ring
from the heightening Alleghenies of Pennsylvania.
Let freedom ring
from the snow-capped Rockies of Colorado.
Let freedom ring
from the curvaceous slopes of California.
But not only that.
Let freedom ring
from Stone Mountain of Georgia.
Let freedom ring
from Lookout Mountain of Tennessee.
Let freedom ring
from every hill and molehill, from every mountainside.
Let freedom ring.
And when this happens,
and when we allow freedom ring, when we let it ring from every village and every hamlet, from every state and every city, we will be able to speed up that day when all of God's children, black men and white men, Jews and Gentiles, Protestants and Catholics, will be able to join hands and sing in the words of the old Negro spiritual.
Free at last?
Free at last.
Thank God Almighty.
We are free at last.
Wow. This man is a true legend. I've only heard of the I Have a Dream speech. I didn't know he did all this, too.
I'm a little disappointed.
Why?
Because after hearing about this man, it makes me feel like I should have listened to more. I mean, this man not only stopped the fight for segregation, but with workers' rights and the voting. It's like this man got so much hate, and he's still looked down on today for helping people inside and outside of his community. Maybe it's just me.
It's not just you. It's me too.
But we didn't just have to hear it.
What do you mean?
What I mean is we don't just have to listen to this. We can embody it too. Just because he isn't around anymore doesn't mean that we can't live up to his legacy today.
I see what you mean. I say when we're done with this project, we go out into our community and find something to stand up for.
Well,
let's get to work.
Thank you so much to Mr. Parker Fitzgerald, the theater teacher at Gunn, and to these fabulous students. Give them another hand. I would like to thank the people who were here from the committee and helped us with the snacks and other things out in the lobby. If they are here, would you all stand up, please, so we can see? They may still be outside. I don't know if they're inside or not. Where are you? Thank you to Nita Halliburton, Tony Kincaid, Wynette Covington, Jackie Englehart, the Altrusa Southeast Tarrant County Early Risers. Thank you to Aaron Perales, our chair. Thank you also to one of our administrators that's here tonight that hasn't been introduced, and that would be Lynn Nguyen, who's the Assistant Director of Visual Arts. And so his students have done the contest with the shirts that you see and with the program cover, and the winning student has their artwork on all of these shirts. So Mr. Nguyen, thank you so much for that work.
So we're going to have a change of pace with this next performance. Coming to the stage will be the Rimenzi Drum Club, and it's directed by Rebecca Meyer. Oh, you guys know them. All right, they are an elite group of fifth and sixth graders who work as a team utilizing advanced musical skills, including complex rhythms, musical interpretation, and creative expression to create entertaining performances. They have performed all around Arlington, including several performances at Sam Houston High School, Levitt Pavilion, and at UTA basketball games. In honor of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr., they will be performing a percussion piece that they wrote themselves to Colors by Jason Derulo. They hope you enjoy this song and appreciate your support. Thank you.
Oh, what a feeling. Look what we've overcome. Oh, I'm gonna wave away my flag. Count all the reasons. We are the champions. There ain't no turning back. Saying, oh, can't you taste the feeling? Saying, oh, y'all get me singing. Look how far we come now. There's beauty in the unity we found. I'm ready. We still got a long way. But look how far we come now. I'm talking.
All right, thank you to those drummers. You guys did an awesome job. Keep up the amazing work. All right, so we are getting ready for an exciting finale for you all. We have AISD's two winning step teams from the MLK competition that took place back in January. So we still want you to enjoy their performances. So the first group that we're going to bring are the elementary winners, and they are representing Adams Elementary, and they were directed by Miss Yolanda Parks.
Way, and I have landed here? What is this place? I must make my journey to the Martin Luther King March at once. Oh, I have got to hear the speech of Dr. Martin Luther King Jr. Dr. King is so smart. He started at Morehouse College at age 15. He has courage, and most of all, he has a heart for all people, no matter their race. I knew I saw you move. Is this your airplane? Can you fly me to hear the speech?
Thank you.
right. First and foremost, I want to say thank you for bringing the Wiz out, meaning like that is an African-American classic film version of The Wizard of Oz. So, and I never would have imagined putting those two together, like stepping with but they did a phenomenal job. All right, guys, I'll see why they were the winners there. So we're going to get ready for another group here representing the junior high. They won. They are from Nichols Junior High, and they were directed by Ashley Cleveland. And I'm proud to say I went back there and I saw a few of my old students from Ellis Elementary School, so I'm proud to see them doing big things at the junior high level. So let's get ready for them.
Stop! on my mama, on my hood. I look fly, yeah. I look good. Touch my swag.
Man, that's what I'm talking about. Let's give it up one more time for the ladies from Nichols Junior High. Representing, I love it. I love it. I love it. Hey, I just want to say thank you. Thank you for being such a great audience tonight, for allowing your children to take part in this significant MLK event. We want to say good evening. Have a safe trip home. We will see you next year.